Hi, welcome to part 2 of the Mapp backup tutorial. In this tutorial, we'll learn how a machine builder can set up Mapp backup to automatically check for software updates and notify the service technician when they're ready for installation. What we want is for the machine to automatically check for new software updates on a weekly basis. The service technician should then be able to start the software update via the HMI application. For this example, we'll use the following MapView HMI application. First, we'll add the MP backup core configuration to enable automatic checks for software updates. That's where we'll find the map link, which uniquely identifies the map component within the map environment. The map link establishes the connection between the application and the configuration. Software updates can be checked for automatically with automatic update. For this to work, the option must be set to notify. The storage medium on which to search for updates is specified under device name. The software updates are made available via an FTP server. Any machine can check this FTP server to see if a new update has been uploaded. The devlink function block is used to establish a connection to the FTP server with the device name FTP. For more information about this function block, see the automation help. Check can be used to determine when to perform the search for new software updates. Since we want to look for updates on a weekly basis, we'll set that to weekly. We've specified a day and time. It's important to note that the time is defined in seconds starting from midnight. In this example, the system will check for software updates every Wednesday at 6 o'clock in the morning. In the next step, the MP backup core function block has already been added and configured. For information about how to configure this function block, watch part 1 of this tutorial. The name parameter of the info structure is used as the name of the software update to be installed. If a new software update is found during the check on Wednesday, it will be entered in the info structure for the MP backup core function block under update. The name of the update that was found is directly linked to the name input. Next, we need to adapt the HMI application. We'll add a group box widget, and it should only become visible when a software update is available. We can do this using the info parameters of the MP backup core function block. The parameter is available is connected to the group box widget's visible property. When an update is available becomes true, and the group box becomes visible. Installation of the update can be started using a button widget. Clicking the button enables the install input parameter of the MP backup core function block. All of the preparations for the machine are now complete, and we're ready to transfer our project to the controller. The machine is now able to check for software updates on a weekly basis and display them in the HMI application. The next step is to prepare a software update. We'll make some changes to the machine application in Automation Studio. Then we need to adjust the version. It must be higher than the version currently installed on the machine. This setting is located in the target system configuration. Next, we'll create a project installation package. When creating the package, we need to specify a data storage location because the data is stored locally before being transferred to the FTP server. More information on this topic can also be found in the automation help. The machine is now connected to the specified FTP server. When a software update has been created, it's displayed on the HMI screen after the next weekly check. The service technician can then update the machine. As you can see, it's very easy to set up an automatic check for software updates using Mapp Backup. Thanks for watching.